Hey guys, it's Julia Maria back with another YouTube video, and today I am at the movie theaters. I am back at my Regal Cinema. I am back at Regal Cinema to see Rocketman. And yes, I am wearing an amazing outfit. But to see this, like, what? Like, love much? Like, love? Like, I'm excited. I'm so excited to see this movie. Like, so excited. I've been a Taron Egerton fan for years now. I am so excited. I'm so excited. I can't even. It feels so amazing to be back at Regal Cinema. I haven't been here. I literally haven't been here since January when I saw Bohemian Rhapsody, this thing along the last time. And I missed Regal. Well, this is just the mall. So I'm in one of the theaters I don't really like. It's the big theaters. I don't like the big theaters because they just feel less intimate. So I'm going the long way because, yeah. I am back at Regal Cinema. I am back at Regal Cinema. Like, what? I'm so excited. I'm just sitting in the hall because, yeah. I'm so excited to see Rocketman because I love Taron. I've already said that. I love Taron. I've been a fan of his for a while now, since like 2017. I'm so excited. And I was a fan of his when he only had like 5 movies on his filmography. I'm just like, oh my gosh, like, stan. And yeah.
I keep trying to hide the way I feel inside.
Oh my gosh, it is so cute that Taron Egerton is playing Elton John because in Kingsman 2, The Golden Circle, Elton John was in it, and obviously Taron Egerton's in Kingsman. What else? In the movie Sing, Taron Egerton, his character Johnny Gorilla, he sings the song in the singing competition by Elton John. I'm still standing. OMG, here is a super fun fact. Okay, so Richard Madden plays John Reed in this movie, and guess what? In Bohemian Rhapsody, Aidan Gillen, I think that's how you say his last name, Aidan Gillen played John Reed in Bohemian Rhapsody. Now, what do they have in common? They were both in Game of Thrones. I don't know if their characters have anything to do with each other because I don't really watch Game of Thrones. I've never actually seen an episode of Game of Thrones, but I know what it's about because I've seen the spoilers. But how cute is that? It's just like a fun little quinky-dink. This picture is honestly me, even though it's not me. That's me, because that's how I sit when I watch, when I'm in a Regal Cinema theater. Sugar, baby. Richard Madden is in this movie, and not gonna lie, Richard Madden is low-key kind of hot. Low-key. But in this movie, he has this really wonky wig. I've seen it from the previews because I haven't seen it yet, but like, what?
To the arcade app.
Hacks for vlogging it in a movie theater. Bring your own light. Guys, you know why I'm gonna be obsessed with this movie no matter what? Because it is directed by Dexter Fletcher. And you know what? When Bohemian Rhapsody's first director, Bryan Singer, got fired, who took over for him? Dexter Fletcher. And I'm just like, I'm gonna love this movie because it's directed by the same kind of director as Bohemian Rhapsody. My favorite movie of all time. Yes. OMG. You guys wanna know something really, 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 really cute? Okay, so since Rocketman is directed by the same director of Bohemian Rhapsody, Rami Malek went to the premiere, and so did Joe Mazzello, and I think Lucy Bogan too, went to the premiere of Rocketman in New York City. Like, that's so cute because Taron Egerton and Rami Malek got a picture together, and that's cute because Elton John and Freddie Mercury were friends in real life. Like, mind blown. And this is the same seat, I think. This is the same seat I sat in when I saw Bohemian Rhapsody sing along. And let's just say I was the only one singing along in the theater.
Does anybody want to take it anymore? The show must go on.
Guys, I'll tell you if Richard Madden is still hot with his wig and Rocketman. I doubt it, but I'll tell you after.
That's what we should want to play tonight. I'll play bodyguard and you play home secretary.
Okay.
Well, actually, not just one. I have all the
questions.
Best part of a road trip. Tom Hanks.
I love Tom Hanks. Tom Hanks. Tom Hanks is in my favorite movie of all time. Tom Hanks is my favorite movie of all time. Tom Hanks is. He is Larry Crone. He is in the movie Larry Crone, and he is Larry Crone. Oh my gosh, I just said it. I am such a fake fan. That's not how you say it. It's Larry Crone, not Larry Crone, even though it's spelled like that, kind of. It is Larry Crone, and I just said it wrong. Some fan I am. Larry Crone, and that's my favorite movie of all time, and I said it wrong. Like. Bohemian Rhapsody.
My favorite movie of all time. Yes.
Larry Crown. And
that's my favorite movie of all time.
I'm a daredevil. JK, no, I'm not. Oh my gosh. Okay, so Rocketman was amazing. Yes, this movie, Rocketman was amazing. Rocketman.
Rocketman.
Taron Egerton is the Rocketman.
Rocketman.
He's the bomb.com. Thebomb.com. Bomb.com. Yes, he is. He's the bomb.com. Because you need to see it. See it. I may be a little biased because I was obsessed. I still am obsessed with Taron Egerton. But, like, my mind is blown by his performance. It's amazing. It's thebomb.com. I already said that. But it's true. It's thebomb.com. No, but, like, seriously. See this movie. I'm just like, what? The movie was 2 hours long, but it literally felt like half an hour, not even, like, what? Like, yes, see it.
Yeah, this one's for you.
Can you even play the piano in those?
Oh, hang on. Hey, don't bother with that one. That wasn't supposed to be in there. That's not by
no,
mistake.
No, that's really good.
To see Elton John.
Sorry, I know.
But oh my goodness gracious. My heart was hurting the whole time for Taron, even though I know it's Elton John who went through that. Like my heart was hurting. Like literally it hurt for Taron. Oh my gosh, like, that's so rude. Like, his family was rude. John Reed was rude. Like, what? But oh my gosh. Okay, so you know how I said, let's see if Richard Madden's hot with that wig. The answer is yes.
Promise my dear, but nothing above ya.
this. Okay, so it was produced by Matthew Vaughn. And if you don't know who Matthew Vaughn is, he's the producer of Kingsman series, and he also produced Eddie the Eagle. And guess what? Taron Egerton was both the was the lead in both of those movies, and he produced this. OMG, you wanna know a coincidence? Kind of. Okay, so Jamie Bell and his wife, Kate Mara,
just had a baby.
And guess what? Rooney Mara is rumored to be engaged
to her boyfriend, Joaquin Phoenix.
Now this is where you get fun. Okay, so Jamie Bell, he's in a movie about Elton John, and Joaquin Phoenix, he played Johnny Cash in Walk the Line. And they're both musical icons, or both in movies about musical icons, and they may be brothers-in-law. And also, here's another fun fact.
Rami was in a movie with Joaquin Phoenix.
And they both played musical icons in their own regards. Like, John Cash was a musical icon in country music, and Rami played Freddie Mercury, who was a legend in pop slash rock. Like, so fun. Okay, so before I saw the movie, I really didn't understand this. But now, after seeing it, I do understand. Okay, so the movie premiered, Rocketman premiered at Cannes, and I saw something how when at the questionnaire at the panel, Taron Egerton's like, I really hope that this movie doesn't get like compared, like I'm not compared to Rami Malek, and this movie isn't compared to Rocketman for like, not Rocketman, Bohemian Rhapsody for like the rest, I don't know, something like that. He said he hopes it doesn't get compared like forever like that, the two movies will be compared. And I see, like, I can see how he feels that, because like they're totally different movies. Like, sure, they're like kind of like the same topic, but the only reason why they're being compared together is because they were released 6 months apart from each other, and because the subjects were friends in real life, and because they're kind of directed by the same person. So I mean, that's why they're compared. But even though they're totally different movies, like Bohemian Rhapsody is like a biopic, and this movie's like a musical slash biopic, but mainly a musical. And I don't know if you could tell the rest of the video, but I really do love Taron Egerton. I really do love this movie, and it's really amazing, and you should see it. And it's like amazing. It's like a musical, and it's really fun, and I love it. And you should watch it because it's really fun, and I think you'd love it too. And yeah, so thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more content. Please give it a thumbs up if you liked it. And yeah, peace out. Love ya.